I'm going to clear up a couple of your questions straight away. Yes, I am from New Zealand, and yes, my accent is sexy enough to make you pregnant. So, should we get stuck in then? Here we go. Bit of background info. My name genuinely is Jared Christmas, and Jared is spelt J-A-R-R-E-D. Thanks, Mum and Dad, that's Jared. It's brutal. And then thanks for that double whammy of a surname Christmas. Woo! High school was a treat. For a whole year, I had a teacher. Whenever she was calling the register in the morning, I was never allowed to go, "Hi, hello, I'm here, good to see you." No. Every morning it was Anders, present, Brown, present, Christmas. This is bullpucky, man. This is rubbish. And I don't want to show off or anything, but I've got an older brother. And he's in the New Zealand Army. It's just him. I know you're all sitting there thinking, New Zealand's got an army. What was the last conflict they were involved in? Lord of the Rings, that's what they did. Did a pretty good job as well. That's right. You join the army anywhere else in the world, you go to Afghanistan. Join the army in New Zealand,
you go to Mordor.
It's all good, but my brother is in the army and obviously shares the same surname as me, and this is true. Last year, he was promoted. He is now Captain Christmas. How wicked is that? He sounds like a seasonal superhero, a really camp seasonal superhero. But no enemy soldier's going to be scared of that. No enemy's going to be in a panic going, "Who are we fighting today, sir? Is it the SAS? Oh no, it's worse than that. Is it the Navy SEALs? Worse than that. Who is it? It's Captain Christmas! Watch out! He's got baubles and tinsel and presents and disappointment." So, it's the, also, I live in London at the moment. I'm married a British girl. Yeah, passport. So, pretty happy about that. And 11 months ago, I had a baby. Well, I didn't. My wife did, but I put it there. So, the thing I'm really excited about is teaching my daughter things. I want to teach her to pronounce one word completely wrong. Like the word guacamole, Guacamole. And the hope is she won't encounter that word outside of the house until she's about 15. I know there's better things in life to hope for, but imagine, it'll be awesome, right? She gets to 15, she hasn't heard that word outside of the house. Next thing, a mate rings up and goes, "Hey, I'm having a party, come on over. It's a Mexican theme." So me and my wife send her off to the party, and me and my wife are giggling, and she gets to the party and she's all excited and she's like, "Guacamole! I love guacamole! Please pass the guacamole!" And me and my wife are waiting at home for her, still giggling. And she arrives home early, of course, and just bursts through the door in tears, really angry, going, "It's guacamole!" And we're like, "Yeah, 15 years, man! 15 years! Wicked!" Oh, dear. A couple of months ago, I got a bit sick. I told a friend of mine my symptoms, and he said, "It sounds like you're getting emphysis." He meant emphysema. I was about to call him an idiot until I realized what a great disease to get emphysis. Imagine having that. What have you got? Emphysis! How do you know you've got that? You just know! Okay? I think William Shatner's got it. He's, he's one of yours, isn't he? You gotta be pretty happy about that. And look, I don't want to get angry or anything, but there is someone out there who I really don't like, and that person's Tiger Woods. That guy's a dick. No, he is. "Oh, I'm addicted to sex. I'm addicted to sex." Oh, well done, Tiger. We're all addicted to sex. Yeah, some of us just aren't good looking enough or rich enough to have sex with anyone we want. We have to stick with one person. "Oh, I'm addicted to sex. I'm addicted to sex. I have to go to rehab." Oh, what happens in there, Tiger? "I don't have sex for ages." Newsflash, Tiger! That's not rehab. That's my 20s. Now, before I go, I have to tell you about New Zealand a bit more. You probably think that we're one of the giants of the military world. Well, you're wrong. I'm here to tell you that. We don't even have an Air Force. We used to have an Air Force, but it was a hand-me-down from the British. All the planes we got from the British. They flew a plane until it couldn't fly anymore, and then they're like, "Well, what do we do with this heap of crap?" I don't know, give it to the Kiwis. They know nothing about flying. Tell them it's a really fancy car. So we get these planes, right? And do you know what the emblem of the New Zealand Air Force is? It's a circle with a Kiwi bird in the centre. Well done, New Zealand Air Force. The emblem is a flightless bird. Not much optimism there that day, was there? You wouldn't want them coming to your rescue if you're a soldier on the front line calling in air support. We need air support. Go USA! Go United Kingdom! Ladies and gentlemen, you're being awesome. I've been Jared Christmas. Have a good night.